Good morning, students. So far in last class, we have completed the revision of the first unit. In the first unit, mainly we have to discuss with that to why the data mining, what is the data mining, and what kinds of the data can be mined, what kinds of patterns can be mined, which technologies we have to use, and which kinds of applications are targeted. And major issues, data objects, attribute types. So nominal attributes, binary attributes. So four types of attributes you have to use. Those are attributes and basic statistical description of data and data visualization, measuring the data similarity and dissimilarity. So these are the concepts you have in the first unit. In the second unit, now we have to revise, that is the data pre-processing. So why you have to do the data pre-processing? So for example, you have the various kinds of data. So these kinds of data, you have to arrange it into the in a particular order. That is, you have to simply call it as in the form of data warehouse. From that data warehouse, you have to retrieve the data through the data mining algorithms. So this first one, whenever you have to arrange it into the in a particular order, that is data pre-processing, you can perform on various kinds of data. So generally, data pre-processing, you have to do four steps you have to follow. One is the data cleaning, data integration, data reduction, and transformation and discretization. So here, this is the data quality, that is the data pre-processing. Here you can get the quality you have to maintain after completion of the data pre-processing. So what are the major tasks we have to perform in data pre-processing is, these are the four tasks mainly we have to perform: data cleaning, integration, data reduction, data transformation, and discretization. First one is the data cleaning. So whenever the data cleaning, after data pre-processing, you can get the quality of the data improved a lot. So why here the data quality, the measures of the data quality, you have to represent it in multi-dimensional view. First one is the accuracy. Whatever the data you have to enter in a databases, that must be correct or wrong, accurate or not. So either true or false, you can represent it with the accuracy. And the completeness. Completeness is not recorded. Live statistics you have to represent it as completeness, unavailable. Consistency, some modified but not dazzling. So whatever the data you have to enter in the databases, that is exactly consistent data. One data is really one word, value is in far high, one value is very low. That is not a consistent. So whenever the book, I have to represent it as consistent manner. That is the consistency, accuracy, completeness, consistency, and timeliness. Timeliness means up to date. The data you have to, whenever you want to enter into the databases, time to time you have to update. That is simply called it as timeliness. And next one is the believability. Simply call it as how trust the data is correct. So whatever the data you have to enter, the data must be correct. Improbability, how easily the data can be understood. That is simply call it as interval. These are the measures of the data quality: accuracy, completeness, consistency, timeliness, timely update, These are regarding to that quality, data quality of the quality measures. So next one is the first task of the data pre-processing is data cleaning. And the second one is the data integration. Third one is the data reduction. And the fourth one is the transformation and discrete. Data cleaning. So data cleaning means here, whenever you want to do the pre-processing, you must be follow these four tasks: data cleaning, integration, reduction, transformation, and discrete. First one is the cleaning. How you have to clean the data. So for example, all the data you have to not fill with the, what are the attributes you have, all the attributes values you should not fill. So that you have to fill the values, filling the missing values, smooth and noisy data, identify and remove the outliers. So actually the range of the particular salary, not less than 1,50,000. So above 1,50,000, you have to this outlier value. So greater than, so the range you have must be subscribed. Within that range, it is okay. It's a far better, far compared to the salary. That is, you have to use the outlier value. That is that type of values we have to identify. That is the outliers. That is identify and remove the outliers, resolving the inconsistency. Like for example, you have to take the another example, age. So actually, age is maximum 100 years or 110 or 20 years. But the value is we have to give it as age is 200. That is the far compared to the range of the age. So that is the identify and remove the outliers and resolve the inconsistencies. You can perform it on data cleaning. So missing values, smoothy, noisy data, identify and remove the outliers, resolve the inconsistency. And the second task is the data integration. So integration of multiple databases, data cubes, files, all data you have to integrate it. And generally data reduced, how the data you have to reduce. One is the dimensionality reduction, numerosity reduction, data compression. That is the data we have to reduce by using these three methods. And the last one is the transformation distribution, normalization techniques we have to apply. That is the normalization and concept hierarchy generation. These are the tasks we have to perform on data pre-processing, data cleaning, data integration, data reduction, and data transformation and discretization. So first one is the data cleaning. How does the data you have to clean? For example, here you have to see that is the data in real world in dirty, lot of potentiality, incorrect data, instrument faulty and human and computer error and transmission error, incomplete lack of attribute values, lacking certain attributes of interest, containing the only aggregate data, occupation, missing data. So particularly the occupation values should not fill with that attribute. That is incomplete and noisy data. Noisy data means actually the always salary must be positive values. But you have to enter the negative values, that is an error. That is not either containing the noise, error, and outlier also. Inconsistent. So inconsistent means containing the dispenses in codes or names, age is 42, birthday is in 2010. It is not inconsistent, but it is not consistent. So this type of data is inconsistent. Actually, age is 42. Birthday date started, birthday is 2010. In approximately 12 years, 11 years. But you have to give an age is 42. That is inconsistent. And the rating also you have to specify 1, 2, 3. And now the rating is ABC. So that is type of data inconsistent. Dispensy between the two duplicate records. So duplicate records also we have to represent it here. And intentional data. So everyone birthday is given as January 1st. So that is the intentionally some data will be entered as a birthday. That is the data cleaning. These are the four types of representation in data cleaning. This is the incomplete data. Data is not always available. Many tuples have no recorded value for the several attributes such as customer income in sales data. Missing data can be maybe due to income equipment malfunction, inconsistent with other recorded data, as deleted, and data is not entered due to misunderstanding. Certain data may not be considered important at your time of entry. So race history of the changes of the data. Missing data can maybe need info. So this type of data are incomplete data. So now how you have to handle this type of missing data? So four types of representations you have to: incomplete, noisy, inconsistent, intention. How these data, missing data, these are the data, how you can handle. So first case, ignore those tuples. Usually done when the class label is missing, not effective the percentage of missing values for attribute, where is considerably. You have to ignore those tuples. Filling the missing values manually. Global variable we have to enter. Fill it automatically. If they have the data, then you have to enter. Fill it automatically with the global constraint is unknown. The attribute mean of all samples belonging to the same class matter. The most probable value. Inference bias would be such as Bayesian formula or regression trees you have to use. And for example, you have to find the mean of the value, and that mean you have to enter. And this is the missing values you have to handle. And how to handle the noisy data? Noisy data is random error and variance is measured by variable. Incorrect attribute values may be due to faulty data collection instrument, data entry problems, data transmission problems, technology limitations, and inconsistency in naming conventions. And other data problems which require the data cleaning, duplicate records, incomplete data, and inconsistent. This is a noisy data. This type of data, how to handle? That is, here you have to handle with the noisy data, like binning, regression, clustering, combine the computer and human inspection. Binning means first to sort the data in partition into equal frequency bins. Then one can move by bin means, smooth by bin median, smooth by bin boundaries, that you have to represent it. Next one is by using the regression, smoothing by fitting the data into the regression functions. Clustering, detect and remove outliers. So here, binning, regression, clustering, and computer and human inspection. Binning means totally the entire data you have to divide into equal frequency bins. And then first, whenever you have that 1,000 records, so all the 1,000 records you have to represent 1 to 100, 100 to 200. So equally frequency bins you have to represent. And you have to find out the mean, each bin mean. The mean and bin median values you have to find. Regression functions you have to apply, that is fitting the data. And clustering, then detecting and remove the outliers. Detecting the suspicious values and check by a human. Data cleaning as a process, data dependency detection. Use the metadata, domain range, dependency, dependency distribution, check field overloading, check uniqueness rule, consecutive rules and null rules. Use the commercial tools, data scrubbing, auditing. So these are the data cleaning as a process, dispensing and detection and migration and integration. So ETL tools, you have to use migration tools. So these all you have to complete in last class, data cleaning. Next one is the integration. In the data integration, you have to combine the multiple sources of the databases. So here you have the different databases, entity identification problem. Identify the real-world entity from the different data sources, like Bill Clinton, William Clinton. Detecting the, resolving the data value conflicts for the same real-world entity attribute values from the different sources from all different. The possible reasons of representation, different scales, biometric, British units you have to use. So for example, customer ID is exactly equal to the B customer ID. So actually both all the customer IDs are different, or customers' IDs are same. So that is the multiple sources you have same data. In some cases, customer IDs are different, but remaining all data you have to equal. That is the data integration. How to handling the redundancy in data integration. A redundant data occurred often when the integration of the multiple databases, object identification, the name, the same attribute or object may have the different names in different databases. Deliverable data, one attribute may be derived with attribute in another table. Annual revenue. Redundant attributes may be able to be detected by the correlation analysis and covariance analysis. So carefully integration of the data from multiple sources may help the reduce and avoid the redundancies, inconsistency, and improve mining speed and quality. So here, covariance and correlation analysis we can do with that redundancy in the data integration. See the examples, chi-square test, whenever you have to apply. The chi-square test is the summation of observed minus expected whole square by expected. That is the by for the nominal data. The larger the chi-square value, the more likely to the variables are related. The cells that contribute the most of the chi-square value are the those whose actual count is very different from the expected count. Correlation does not imply the causality. The hash of number of hospitals is number of cars left in the city are correlated. Both are causally linked. Third variable, population. See this example, like a science fiction. Play chess and not playing chess. Both the people have the sum is 450. And not like science fiction, play chess is 50 and not play chess is 1000. The sum is 1050. And each column wise you have to represent the sum. Play chess is 300, but not playing chess is 1200. Totally you have the 1500 people are there. So now we want to find out the chi-square calculation for that given data. Expected counts calculated based on the data distribution categories. 250, actually playing chess is 250. And Two 50 minus 90 whole square by Expected actually I've observed is 250, but expected is only 90. Here expected 90, but you are getting 250. So the chi square, well, you have to find out 250 minus 90 whole square by 90. And similar way, pledges 50 minus actual expected is 210, but you are getting the third only 50. 50 minus 210 whole square by 210. And similar way, not playing chess, 200 minus 360 by 60, the whole square by 360. And similar way, 1000 minus 840 whole square by 840. So finally, you can get the all the summation value 507.93. It shows that like since so like signs friction and play chess are correlated in the group. The correlation coefficient you have to find out, like this is the Pearson products moment coefficient. And where n is the number of tuples, and a bar and b bar, the respective means of the a and b. And rho a and rho b are the respective standard deviations of a and b. Summation of ai bi is the sum of the ab cross product. If the r of the avi, the correlation coefficient value is greater than zero, that is the positively correlated, higher the value is higher, the stronger correlation between. If the RAB equal to zero, that is independent, both are independent, and RAB is less than zero, that is negatively correlated. So this is visually evaluating the correlation between the minus one to plus one. Correlation measures is the relationship between the objects. To compute the correlation, we standardize the data objects A and B and take the dot product. The correlation A bar and dot B bar. The coherence on numeric data. The coherence is similar to the correlation, the relationship between the variables. And E of A bar, A comma A bar and B comma B bar equal to summation of 1 to N. That is AI minus A bar, BI minus B bar by whole power divided by N. The correlation coefficient R of AB, coherence of AB divided by standard deviation of A and standard deviation of A. Where N is the number of tuples, A bar, B are the respective means of the respected values of A and B, and standard deviations of A and B that you have to represent it as rho a and rho b. The positive coherence already is greater than zero. It's larger than high expected values. Negative coherence is always is smaller, that is smaller than its expected values. So both coherence and the values is zero, that is the converse is not true. Example here it shows that coherence between the variables. Suppose two stocks A and B on the following values in 1 week, 2, 5, 3, 8, 5, 10, 4, 11, 6, 14. So you can find out the first value, that is the E of A, that is the average you have to find out, that is the 4. And the average of the B, that is the 9.6. So now you can find out the coherence value between the A and B, and 2 into 5. That is a 2 into 5 plus 3 into 8 plus 5 into 10, 4 into 11 and 6 into 14 divided by 5 minus. That is the value of E of A value and E of B value, 4 into 2, 9.6. So now you can get the value, that is the 4. So 4 is always greater than 0. It is a arise together and you have the stronger coherence between these values. This is regarding to the data interpretation. Next one is the data integration. Data integration mainly you have to represent it as data integration is just now we have to complete the correlation coherence, and next one is the data reduction. In the data reduction, mainly we have to reduce the representation of data set. It's much smaller in volume, but it produces the same analytical results. Data warehouse may store terabytes of the data. Complex data analysis may take very long term to run on the complete data set. Data reduction strategies, generally we have to represent it. Dimensional reduction, among the unimportant attributes, numerosity reduction, and data compression. Dimensional reductions mainly have to be represented with three ways: Weberle transforms, PCA, principal component analysis, feature subset selection, feature creations. That all you have to comes under this one. Numerosity reduction, so simply call it as data reduction. Regression, log linear models, histograms, clustering, samples, data cube aggregation. These all are numerosity reduction. And the last one is the data compression. See the dimensional reductions. See the cursor of the dimensional reductions and the dimensional reduction techniques. So here you have to use the three techniques: Weberle, principal component analysis, and supervised nonlinear techniques. So avoid the cursing of the dimensionality. You have to reduce by the dimensional. So Fourier transforms and Weberle transforms you have to represent it with the frequency and sine waves. What is the Weberle transform? So there's a diagram which shows that decomposing a signal into different frequencies, subbands. Weberle transform, discrete the Weberle transform for the linear signal processing, multi-resolution analysis. See the Weberle decomposition of the given data, S equal to 220.235.422 can be transformed into the Weberle transform, that is the S of 2^3/4 -1, 1/4, 1/2, 0, 0, -1, -1, 0. How you can get these values? That is the detailed coefficients values 220.235 and 2/4. That is the average you have to find out for the our actual resolution is 8. But in this resolution, you can find out the values. The 8 out of 8, you have to convert into 4. That is the 2 average is 2 + 2/4, 2. That is the average 2. And 2 + 0/2, that is the 1. 2 + 3, that is the 4. Or 3 + 5 = 4, and 4 + 4/4. Similar way, 2, 1, that is the 3/2, and 4, similar way to 3/4. So like this way, we have to getting these values. 1 and 2 is represented as -1/4. Detail coefficients you have to represent it here. This is the Haar Weberle coefficients. Why Weberle transform hash shaped filters you have to use for the multi resolution and principles of component analysis, that is the PCA. The projection of the captures the large amount of variation data is called as principal component analysis. See this diagram, it shows that whatever the dot points you have, that all comes under the one cluster. That is the principal component analysis, so you can find out with this value. So number step by step process, you have to normalize the input data and build the other vectors. Each input data vector is a linear combination. The principal components are sorted in order to the decreasing. And attribute subset selection, reduce the dimensionality of data, redundant attributes, irrelevant attributes, heuristic search in attribute selection. That is the two-dimensional possible attributes, a combination of the attributes. Best stepwise feature selection, stepwise attribute elimination, best combined the attribute selection and elimination, optimal branch and bound. Attribute creation, the feature generation can do with that. These are the dimensionality reduction for that. Numerosity reduction. So in the numerical reduction, we have to reduce the data in the various forms of the data representation, parametric and non-parametric methods we have to use. And the parametric and non-parametric methods, regression and non-linear log-linear models are represented as parametric. Linear regression, straight line between the two points. And multiple regressions, more than two variables, we have to relationship, you have to represent multiple regressions, log linear models. So the regression analysis of the different dependent variable and response variables. See the linear regression and multiple regressions of variables. So relationship between the two variables, that is the linear regression. And more than one variable, we have to represent it as multiple regressions. Histogram analysis. You can do all these clustering. Clustering means whatever the group of points you have to represent it as cluster. The partition of data set into a cluster based on their similarity and store cluster representations. It's a very effective. Data is clustered, but not if data is paired. Here, this is the sampling. Obtaining this small sample as to represent the whole set data set in. And the mining algorithms you can apply it for that. So we'll continue in next class. So today I will give the assignment questions. Please note down it. And then after it must be submitted after 10 days.